Yes, so we're here with our patient right now doing PRP injections into the scalp. This is to stimulate hair growth. You could do it before, after, or not even related to hair transplants. In this case, we did the hair transplant already. Now we're stimulating further growth. The point of injecting PRP, and this is real PRP, as opposed to kind of just, you know, withdrawing a little bit of blood. We draw actually a ton of blood and spin it down. Is that you're injecting signaling factors into the skin, which help promote healing. We're also injecting platelet poor plasma right after this with A cell, which is a embryonic cell matrix, more as a matrix for the actual growth of or stimulation of hair follicles. So you have your little progenitor cells. From that, or fat, we like to use fat as well. And then you have your signaling factors from the PRP, which is what you're injecting. So as you can see, these are all little tiny holes over here. Every little dot you see that I'm injecting platelet-rich plasma into. Gets your arm tired after a little while, but...
Hey, Michael, someone on Instagram is asking if it hurts. How do you feel?
I feel fine. Can't feel a thing.
So we did a ring block on him. Ring block goes all the way around the scalp, and it keeps the scalp numb for about an hour. When you do a real PRP injection like this, you're good for about 6 months. It's not like the other PRP injections, though, where you can go back to work the same day. This is a little more hardcore, does get a better result, but you're swollen usually for about 4 days, and it can drift down around your eyes, so it's something to remember. And again, I'm rejecting PRP, microneedle technique, and then we're gonna do PPP, which is platelet poor plasma, with A cell. Alright, so not much more exciting after this. We should see growth within the next 3 months, and then repeated at 6 months.